Noah. That's the mentality we have to have.
Yes.
Whether you want to believe it or not, you're in a war.
Yes.
Yeah, man, you have to change your strategy. Praise God Almighty. And Joshua had to develop a new strategy. A one of war. Because God said, drive them out. He never said, go in and sit down and dine with them and talk to them and promise them and listen. No. He said, drive them out. He couldn't be like Moses and plead with them. No, man. Whenever you drive out somebody, man, your weapons, you have to have weapons. Your mentality has to change. All your things have to change because you say, I drive out now. No, man, you have to sit on that interval with them and entertain them. So your mindset has to be different. You have to drive them out and war with you now. You have to go take some people and take them for it.
Yes.
Because I'm not up with the Canaan, I thought Canaan's when they was there. Of Chewy land, this whole thing, you come in and come drive me up. Who would it be?
Their
name suggests. So who these foreign people coming up come tell me, say, they might drive me out of the motherland. War of the start and war of a man. So because Moses was so meek.
Yes.
That's why, you know, when David went to Bible, but David said, I want me to attend. I want to be in a temple who was house of presence, man.
Yes.
He said, no, I know you. You're not the nature of man for being that the kind of thing. You're not bloody man.
Oh,
Jesus. That's what I mean. So, David work finished and Solomon was started. Because Solomon was a more of a calm demeanor.
Yes.
And he was in, yes, his mind different, you know. And Solomon was wise.
Yes.
Solomon, David know how to war, man. Put him in a war, man, and you can't war. Yes, honey, in a helmet. Put your teachers to cover your teacher, your teacher. You understand what I mean? But me don't know, me, trust me, I couldn't, me don't know how to do it. Sister Dana, the children, they want to get them quiet, and get them big, but guess what? You guys don't know, you don't know the element of what I don't do. You understand what I mean? But put minister, and me don't know, or somebody else, they might not be able to do it, you understand? So David was a warrior man. And he's like, yes, God, put me before Goliath, and this me God for Goliath, and this me how to do, give me this sleep, man. Oh, you're in the element, you know. Yes, man. I kill me, kill, man. This is what I do. I'm a warrior. But Solomon, I love her. Yeah, man, Solomon, I love her. He was a different demeanor. And any time he was in that rest, and he was wise, and he knew how to a book smart man, and he knew how to send to lumber here, so you know. You know what I mean? So your nature also determines even the kind of gift where God will give you, and all those different things, compliment. So now what? Moses, lawgiver man. Moses knew how to orchestrate and go up and to hear from God, write and come back down and present and do all these different things. Moses is a word man, book man, you know, legislate. Yeah, man, put government, put things into. But guess what? When you need a warrior, he said to Joshua. It's just like we're in church here. When we need an intercessor, man, you have to send for one intercessor. You understand me? When you want one intercessor, I'm not. You know, people pray and people have their different gifts and callings and ways of doing things. But when someone radical and go on, man, you understand me? I have to send me somebody that can radically deal with it. Yeah, man, we're training that department. So when demons step up, man, you know, I'm going to send me somebody with a calm demeanor. And whatever shall I say? Jesus. I'm not saying that we are infected, but they will need somebody man where they struck on some people and says, okay, man, in the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth, take it out. You understand? Leave. You understand? You need healing. You send somebody who you know who is trained in the ministry of healing. You understand what I mean? So Joshua, no man, a warrior man. Give the sword, man, and you ready. You ready to draw it and to kill her. You understand what I mean? So, guess what? Moses is dead, but not Joshua will continue. It is just in every scenario. When you look at it, Elijah and Elisha. Elijah, you know, his demeanor probably was different than Elisha. And so where he stopped off, because Elijah said, I want to do double the amount of and miracles that Elisha did. So Elisha had, he was younger, so he had a little more zeal and strength to do certain things that Elijah was not able to do. And this is why in ministry, we can't compare. You cannot compare yourself with somebody else. You understand what I mean? You cannot compare yourself. You work in your office and your ministry, and you're effective in how you're doing and what you're doing. You understand what I mean? You can't look at Mr. Harper and say, my God, when he prayed, he sound like thunder. I don't want to pray like that, but you know what I mean? Mr. Harper voice rough too. You understand what I mean? So when he come and he said, Lord, let me go down in that voice there. You understand what I mean? You will not feel me a voice. You can't go down in that voice there and say, God, yeah. You understand what I mean? When you want somebody to hoop on high, you call Minister Williams. And when you have, and he go along and you have, and he come about, guess what? You understand? This is easy now. Somebody is not going to be able to pay. I could do that, but guess what? We are effective in our own different ways. When you want a worshiper, praise God Almighty, and you're like a sister Brown Staniki, she have a weeping anointing. You know, when you want somebody to travel and to weep before the Lord, I think Sister Nikki is a suitable candidate for that. Weep, you know, prophets who weep, you know, they bawl, weeping prophets. You understand what I mean? So a different nature. As I was saying earlier, you have to learn to detect and to see how a person operates. When you want somebody to roll in the church, you can't call me. Can't hear me run around, you understand what I mean? But if you have somebody else where, you know, where they can sit one place, but then guess what? That same person can sit in another one place and they don't say a word, but they just say they are praying. Come on. Can you have power in the church too, you know? Somebody step up here, send a minister, and everybody have a minister, but somebody don't let him come and say, come on. You just sit in the mouth and move. Come on. And this is where, you know, I sat there and I said, God, you know, if she does call me again, I believe, and based on my ministry, just give me a scripture or a word, and I can make a sermon. Yeah, I can make a sermon out of practically anything. It's not a boast, but that's what I see happening. I can make it out of anything. And when we see the Jericho experience and the Jericho, what God instructed Joshua to do, to go around Jericho and to shout and the walls fell down. It was a miracle because the wall was said to be so thick. Yes. They said two chariots couldn't ride. What the word is? Conjunction to one another. Yes, right. So, you know, it was a very thick wall. And to understand that, please. God didn't tell Moses in his time to praise anything, you know, praise the way out of anything, you know. But in that sense, he told Joshua to use praise to bring down the walls of Jericho. Yes. So your weapon that he gives you is different from my weapon. Yes. And if he says, this time I want you to use praise to bring down the walls of Jericho, then a praise you must use. Yes. You understand what I mean? You must use praise. Because that is what is going to be effective to bring down the walls of Jericho. Moses sent 12 spies, but Joshua said, he might have said, I don't want nobody to come back with no bad news. He only sent two this time. And they sent two, and the two was effective. Rahab, they met Rahab and all of that transpired. Guess what? You have to work in your own ministry, work in your own calling, work into what God gave you. When Sister Dana stood up and sing the song, I love him too much to fear him now. You understand what I mean? He brought in the service a period of worship. You understand what I mean? Reflection. God, you know, this thing that I have, they're just borrowed, they're not mine. But Jesus only let me use them to brighten my life. So remind me. So that brought me to the service a moment of reflection. You see where you take me from, Lord? I know where I could have been, but where I am today. So that praise, that song, interjected into the service, made such a difference. Amen? Amen. Praise God. So here we have praise. My God, praise. It's not praise is what I do.
Yes.
And they used praise to break down the walls of Jericho. And they went in. But instructions were given to Luca, destroy everything. Destroy everything. Okay, not putting